वेलकम टू एवरीबॉडी ऑन ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ संत माइकल्स एकेडमी। माई सेल्फ राकेश रंजन श्रीवास्तव, साइंस टीचर इन संत माइकल्स एकेडमी। इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो आई एक्सप्लेन अबाउट फ्लावर, देयर पार्ट्स एंड ऑल्सो देयर फंक्शन। आई एक्सप्लेन ऑल दिस टॉपिक्स प्रैक्टिकली बाय द हेल्प ऑफ ए फ्लावर। Here is a flower and also this is bisexual flower. It means both male and female parts present in this flower. So step by step we all try to understand about each part and their function practically about this flower. This is a flower of hibiscus rosa chinensis and also this is a complete flower. At first, what is flower? Everybody know about flower, that flower is the most important and reproductive part of the plant. And also two types of flower, complete and incomplete flower. In complete flower, all the four types of holes present, and also in incomplete flower, all parts are not present. So this is a complete flower and also all the four parts present in it. At first, we will try to know about this structure. At first, this is the basal part of the flower. And also this basal part is called pedicel. This is called pedicel. And upper part of this is called thalamus. And from thalamus, there is a part, green part present in the flower. This green part is called sepal. Sepal is the green part of flower and also it keeps shape the flower from the stage of bud and finally at the stage of blooming the flower and also support and basal part of this called sepals. And this sepal, each and every part of this called sepal and combinedly this whole is called calyx. It means the lower part is called calyx and in calyx many sepals are also attached to each other in a ring way and this is the called first hole of the flower. Now you will try to know about this. This is a green part and this is also called sepals and each sepal combinedly form the calyx. It means basal part of the flower. So this complete hole is called calyx and each part given here. And this each part is called sepal and combinedly this complete hole is called calyx and these sepals attached to the basal part called thalamus and the lower part of this is called pedicel and this part is called thalamus and from thalamus attached this calyx. This is the first hole of the flower and each sepal combinedly called calyx. Now the second hole of the flower. Here is given the color part of the flower is called second hole of the flower. And each part, suppose this is the one part of this flower. This is very colorful and also help in the pollination. Because various types of animals, insects and also human beings attract by the beauty and color of the flower. And this part is called petal. This single part is called petal and many petals attached in a sequence. And also each part, this is called petal and they combinedly form a whole. This single part is called petal. And also combinedly all the petals form the second hole of the flower. दिस इज कॉल्ड कोरोला. कोरोला आर कंबाइंड फॉर्म ऑफ द पेटल्स. ऑल द पेटल्स कंबाइंड टूगेदर एंड फॉर्म ए होल. दिस इज कॉल्ड कोरोला. दिस इज द सेकेंड होल ऑफ द फ्लावर. नाउ दिस इज द थर्ड एंड फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर. हियर इज गिवेन ए स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल्स हियर एंड हियर लार्ज नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल प्रेजेंटिंग दिस होल. दिस होल इज कॉल्ड थर्ड होल ऑफ द फ्लावर एंड ऑल्सो दिस कंप्लीट पार्ट. There are many small part present here. This is the third hole of the flower. And this, each part in this hole, third hole is called stamen. Here is given the part, this is called stamen. And this stamen also including two parts and called the third part, it means male part of the flower. And also called whole part is called stamen and the upper part is called anther and the long tubular structure is called filament. So in the third hole of the flower, which is called male part of the flower, and in this part the upper part is called anther and the lower part is called filament. So this is the third hole of the flower and also called male part of the flower. And generally the male part of flower is also called androecium. And their function is to carry pollen grains and also help in the reproduction. Now in the last, you all study about the fourth hole of the flower. We all remove your third hole and after them, in the last there are the fourth hole present. This is the fourth hole of the present. This is called pistil. This is a long structure. All part is called pistil. And pistil is called the female part of the flower and also fourth hole of the flower. And here is pistil and this is also divided into three parts. The upper part is the pistil is also disc-like structure and also this fourth hole combinedly called gynoecium. And the upper part of this female part of the flower is disc-like structure and also called stigma. And also this stigma attached a long filamentous structure. This is the long filamentous structure. This is called style. And this style in the last attached to is the swollen part. This is called ovary. So this pistil means female part, means gynoecium, also made from three parts. The upper part is a disc-like structure called stigma. Middle part is a filamentous structure called style. And the lower part is swollen part called ovary. So these three part commonly form the fourth hole of the flower and called fourth part of the flower, means female reproductive part of the flower. Now we all know about each and every part of the flower. First lower part, lower hole is called sepal, and second part colorful part is called petal, and after them the third part which is called male part of the flower called anther, including stamen, upper part, and also lower filamentous part is called filament. And in the last fourth hole is called pistil, female part of the flower. This including three part, stigma, style, and ovary. Stigma is the upper part of the flower. This is a disc-like structure and also a sticky material present in it. And this is the long part of this. And also in the last, the ovary present. Now from this part, upper part of stigma, there is a tubular structure developed. And also this tubular structure developed and reach to the ovary. By this tubular structure, pollen grains, it means male gametes coming in the ovary and fertilization completed. So now try to know about this pollen tube. This is the female part, and also inside it, when we cut this part internally, inside this tubular structure develop a tube like structure. You will see this tube like structure, and by the help of this tube like structure, pollen grains from the stigma enter inside the ovary. This is the tubular structure. This is the tubular structure, and this is the lower part, ovary. So this is the upper part called stigma, and also from stigma tubular structure develop and coming through the ovary, and also inside the ovary हो जाए. नाउ मेनी फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स कॉल्स ओव्यूल्स प्रेजेंट इनसाइड दिस ओवरी. दीज आर द ओव्यूल्स एंड ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द ओवरी. सो दीज आर द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लावर. And also by this flower in ovary, this female gamete also present. This is called ovules, and also they help in the fertilization. Now these are the structure of flower. Now what is the process of fertilization in the flower? As we all study about, four whore present in the flower, and also male and female part present in the flower, anther and stigma, stamen and pistil. Stamen is called female part, and pistil is called female part, and stamen is called male part of the flower. So pollen grains present on the upper side of this is called anther, and also yellowish material present on the upper part. This is called pollens. And also by any method, when this pollen grains move down on the upper part of female part, it means on the stigma. This stigma is a sticky part, and also this pollen grains from coming here and also stick here on the upper part of stigma. And also these are also called male part and male gametes. And this male part present on a stigma, and they develop a tubular structure. This is called pollen tube. And by the help of this tube, this male gamete also come and enter inside the ovary. And also they fuse with female gamete. It means egg cell or ova. And also fertilization completed. So students, in this part of video we all try to understand practically about flower and their parts, and also which part present, and also which part help in which function. So everybody try to understand this practically, and also try to take a flower and also do this work separately to try to better understand about these topics. So students, I complete this part of video. Thank you.